principal at Oviedo High School says an investigation turned up no facts in a threat a student made about shooting up the school. There was extra security on campus this morning just as a precaution. The principal assured all students and parents that the school was safe. WESH 2's Gail Pascoe Brown joins us now live. And Gail, when did the school first learn about the threat?
Well, actually, they learned about it last Friday, but as they dug deeper, they found out there was a similar complaint on January last month, the 17th. Now, in both instances, in one of them, a mother contacted the dean saying that she was concerned because of a couple that had had a breakup and there was a threat to bring a gun on campus. Then another time, there was another threat, even a Facebook page of the boy holding guns threatening to shoot up the school. But Oviedo police investigated both of this. Nothing substantiated, but it was enough to get the principal of Oviedo High School concerned, and he went into action today. Oviedo police stepped up patrols Wednesday at Oviedo High School after last week's alleged comments by a 10th grader off campus to shoot up the school. Another student reported to the dean.
A kid threatened to shoot the school, but it already got resolved.
My principal, Mr. Lundquist, he handled the situation very well. He went on the overcom and he told us that they were handling it, that they got officers and everything.
Next is it began to go viral, if you will, on Facebook. And as the social media took over, the principal felt that this is something that he needed to get out in front of.
Today, the principal, Dr. Robert Lundquist, went on the intercom telling students that last week there was an off-campus threat by one of our students who said he was going to shoot up the school. This led to an investigation by the school and the police department. The findings were no facts sustaining the rumor.
I knew about it last week. I didn't take it seriously because it was just like a threat, you know.
After an investigation, it was also uncovered that the 10th grader made a similar comment last month. The student withdrew from Oviedo High School.
Certainly, we always want to keep the parents in the loop to the extent that we can. But remember, these were unsubstantiated rumors and allegations of a statement.
Now, tomorrow, Oviedo High School is going to practice a code red drill. That is the highest alert. It was a drill that, of course, was set up months before any of this. Now, the student, as I mentioned, has withdrawn from school. But if Seminole County Public Schools find out that there was any wrongdoing whatsoever, they still can take action. Coming up at 5 o'clock, we'll tell you about one parent who didn't want to go on camera about her concerns, that she had to get text messages and a picture from her student to find out about all of this. I'm Gail Pascoe Brown, live in Seminole County for WESH 2 News.